Before we begin, let me start by saying, how is it possible that a movie with no sound says more in 68 minutes than a modern-day blockbuster with a runtime of 2 hours and 45 film minutes of obnoxious kabooms, big bazooms, and skin-tight costumes? Because Charlie speaks with his eyes. The stars of our movie today are Uncle Fester and Robert Downey Jr. He wishes. No offense, RDJ. Play! Our story begins with... Oh, I already know y'all ain't gonna like this. Words. But it really begins with this poor lady who can't afford to take care of her little pudding dumpling because the daddy done run off thinking he was gonna be able to pay off his student loans from his art degree by painting. Guess nobody told him that the only good paying jobs are in CGI. Sad. Okay, daddy's not in the picture, but he does burn his honey, so he don't have to be in it. Oh, I'm so sorry. Is this boring, y'all? Alright, I'ma turn it up. The mama knows that she can't take care of this little pudding dumpling on her own, so she leaves him in the back of a rich man's car. Then it gets hijacked by criminals who leave the baby for dead behind a pile of trash. Just then, the baby is found by this classy trash known as the Tramp and finds a note that says, I'm broke, take care of this kid. And he takes the boy in and teaches him to fight crime. And the kid grows up to become Batman! No, I'm just kidding. He actually grows up to work for his adopted father's business. Chaplin and Son. Window Destruction and Repair. But as victims of a corrupt legal system, they are frequently chased by officers just for trying to be hard-working citizens. But still they endure and survive on... whatever the hell that is. Okay, I gotta give it a rest for a minute. So the mama, she in the big bucks now because it's easy to follow your dreams when you ain't gotta take care of one of those lifelong parasites y'all call kids. But to deal with the guilt of her only child being who the hell knows where, she gives to little kids in the poor neighborhoods. And apparently it never occurred to her that she might just run into her own and not know it. Oh, for God's sake, I can see the Z's floating over y'all's heads. Alright, I'ma turn it up again. The kid becomes sick and Charlie scrapes together what he can to pay for a doctor. But the doctor is shown the note the kid was left with and discovers that the child is not the Tramp's. So the authorities come to take the child away, even though when he was starving in the street I didn't see them offering up a spare tit. And the Tramp feels the same, so he fights them off even as the child is pried from his home. The Tramp vows to get him back and dashes across the rooftops to ambush the truck full of child traffickers, chasing off the corrupt abductors. Get the hell out of here, you piece of s***! I didn't see you offering up a tit! That's right, keep running, bit! Oh lord, I'm getting a headache talking like this.
I don't know how Batman does it.
Meanwhile, Mama finds out that she's been giving gifts to her own child all along, and she puts out a $1,000 reward for anyone who finds him. Now fugitives of the law, the Tramp and the child can no longer return to their home, and must seek shelter in a flophouse. I'm sorry, there's just no cool way to say flophouse. But betrayal strikes, the kid is abducted again in the middle of the night for the $1,000 reward, and the Tramp searches for him until dawn when he passes out on their stoop. I'm sorry, there's just no cool way to say stoop. There he enters Dreamland where he sees the kid as one of Charlie's angels. And to no surprise, Charlie himself is an angel too. Then he does battle with Sin itself and starts Iron Man fronting. And don't you dare scoff, because if that was the plot to a new Avengers movie, y'all be messing your Marvel under rules. After which he is awoken by a police officer who drags him away to an unknown house, where he sees the kid has been reunited with his long-lost mother, gets a handshake from the police officer, and gets invited inside for some tea.
The end.
Be sure to like, share, and subscribe for your regular fix of meth. You can expect me to upload more videos whenever I want to explain action-packed silence. For movies explained for, I'm Jeb. A dire. And one final word to pay respect to the late, great Stan Lee, whose autograph is one of my most cherished possessions. Thanks for all you did, Stan. Excelsior.